No problem. So we started a new book, and before we go into to the book itself, there is an overview, and I just glance of this over to the overview. So it talk about all the spiritual things that connect to the observance of the mitzvahs, and of course the mitzvah of eating kosher. So I think it would be beneficial for us to go through this overview. Maybe we're going to finish in a few classes, but maybe one class, I don't know, we'll see. But there is a lot of very interesting information. And just to say about this topic, Kosher Kitchen, so we never cover this topic per se. We were talking about Shabbos Kitchen. So even though the word kitchen is the same, but there we were not talking about kosher, just we were talking about melacha pertaining to Shabbos. And in our class of Kitzer Shulchan Aruch, we also talk about kosher foods, but it's a just general overview. So here we're going to go on all of the possible scenarios and details. Beezrat HaShem. Okay, so let's start. It is appropriate that one meditate according to his intellectual capacity regarding the laws of the Torah to understand their deep meaning. These laws, which he finds no reason and knows no purpose, should nevertheless not be treated lightly. Okay, so who said it? Rambam Hilchas Meila 8:8. So even though Rambam teaches us, first we have to do, of course, and then we have to learn. So that's the proper way. Don't question the mitzvah while you're doing it. You do according to whatever they taught you, according to whatever the book says, and then in the process you learn about deep meaning. But for sure you have to learn about the mitzvah, every mitzvah in details as much as you can, right? And contemplate. Continue. Reason or faith. Throughout the ages, Torah observant Jews followed the dictates of the Torah as a matter of basic faith. That is as it should be. Our adherence to the Torah and its laws cannot be dependent upon finding any of them satisfactory. This is the principle of Ma'aseh v'Nishma. We will accept and we will hear. The declaration of the commitment, which preceded the receiving of the Torah itself. So let's stop here and try to understand what we are saying here. So our faith is based on that we're doing not because it's good for us. So of course, right? Not because it's good for us. Not because of the big reward that we're going to get. Even though this answer is also true, but we're doing the mitzvahs because Hashem said so. Right? So Hashem said that's it, right? That's what we must do, and that's it, and we'll be doing it. And it's easier to withstand all of the life tests because there is no condition, right? I mean, if person is going to do because he's going to benefit, right? So once the benefit is over, so he's going to stop doing mitzvahs, right? Because he was keeping Shabbos and his business doubled, but then business went down. And he said, okay, the Shabbos thing did not work out for me so well, so I'm going to stop. You understand? So our approach, and when we teach others, we keep the mitzvahs because Hashem said so. Okay. Acceptance of this principle, unconditional commitment to the will of Hashem, is a prerequisite of the acceptance of the Torah. See Shaarei Teshuvah 2:10. Okay, so one more time, we're doing mitzvahs because Hashem said so. Of course, it does not contradict that we have to learn about deep meaning of the mitzvahs. There is two separate things, right? The more person learns about the mitzvah, the more he loves it, and the more he understands, he or she understands it. One who puts the commandments of Hashem under the scrutiny before irreversibly assuming their fulfillment is essentially not accepting the dictates of the Hashem, but rather those of his own intellect. So a person say, okay, this mitzvah, they say it's good, so how is it good? And he's trying to understand, should I do it or should not do it, right? If I'm going to have time, I'm not going to have time. that's already the person started going in the wrong direction when he's trying to use his intellect. So with our intellect, so Hashem always say, and not all, but at least a few times in the Torah says, my thoughts are not your thoughts. So we don't have an intellectual capacity to understand Hashem. So, and why he said so. Okay. He recognizes no higher authority than that of his judgment. Meaning this person. So if I understand, I'm going to do it. If I don't understand, I'm not going to do it. As Rabbeinu saw Yonah appointedly states, for if the servant says to his master, I will do all that you tell me except one thing, he has shed the yoke of the master and does what is fitting in his own eyes. Sharei Teshuva 1:6. So it's very interesting example. So servants, I'm going to do everything what the master said except one thing. And this one thing could be the smaller things. He said that you have to wear, I don't know, black shoelaces, and said, no, I'm going to wear brown shoelaces. So one thing I don't agree about the shoelaces, that's enough to be rebellious. Okay? Even though he accept all of the big things. So it's already he throwing off the yoke of the master, right? And he said, I have my own intellect decide what I should and what I should not do. And of course, it's we have to see ourselves, like, and check ourselves and contemplate and see if we are not in the same position of this slave, right? Not a slave or student or whoever, or Jew, right? The one who is trying to contemplate mitzvahs and say, this is good, this is very good, but this, I don't know, maybe, okay, I'm accepting, but I don't agree. That's the problem. Okay. Acceptance of the Torah entails subordination to the law, regardless whether or not we can intellectually comprehend the logic or emotionally identify with them. Okay, so it's very interesting. I mean, that's very clear statement, but let's read it again and we're going to explain. Acceptance of the Torah entails subordination to its laws regarding whether or not we can intellectually comprehend the logic, emotionally identify with them. Okay, so here's so it says here, so acceptance of the Torah, so we cannot involve our intellect. So intellect has to come second, right, to try to understand, but first we do. And especially emotions. So the problem is many people emotions, and many people cannot be judges, for example, right? Why? Because they're very emotional. They would not think with the intellect, right? They would think with the emotion, and it's easier to cheat people like that, like to confuse them, right? In these emotional people. And Torah said not to be so, right? And if Torah said, for example, somebody is innocent because we don't have evidence, right? So you have to let it go. So if it was, for example, give this example that one person kills another and it was only one witness. So that one single witness cannot go to court and testify. Cannot. So we're learning laws of Lashon Hara. So these people, these judges in the court, they're not allowed to hear testimony of single witness. Clear. So people say, yeah, this murderer, this rapist, he's going to do whatever he wants. Right? That there's no justice, that Hashem is limited, Chas v'Shalom. That's what people say. Why? Because they judge the situation based with their emotions. You understand? That's not what we do. We do with intellect. Continue. This being so, any examinations of the meaning of the mitzvah seems superfluous, right? So it's very interesting statement. So if I have to do it, and whether I understand it or not, so what does it matter? That doesn't make a difference. I understand or not. So maybe don't waste my time. Why bother explaining something that requires no rationalization? So if there is no human rationalization, Right? So why do I need to learn? Okay, it's a good question. The fact that Hashem commanded us to perform a mitzvah is a reason enough, indeed the only reason, that is the mitzvah, must be carried out. Right? So as we said before, like the author is trying to ask the question, why do we need to learn deep in the mitzvah, like a reason for this mitzvah, right? If we, the only reason that we must know that Hashem said so, and this is the main reason. Okay. Nevertheless, Rambam's ruling clearly states, so we're going to see, that not only one is permitted to meditate upon the meaning of the mitzvahs, it is appropriate to do so. Okay, so that's not how Rambam teaches. Of course, he said that you have to do anyway, but you must meditate and you must learn deep inside. Herein lies a dilemma. Granted that we should ponder on the mitzvahs, but isn't this ultimately an existent exercise in futility? Can a finite mind of man actually grab the infinite wisdom hidden with each mitzvah? Surely any interpretation that we may offer as a product of human understanding, can our limited faculties comprehend and encapsulate the true meaning of the divine mitzvah? Perhaps we need to re-examine the purpose of attempting to understand the mitzvahs. So he's asking all of these good questions, like as we quote before, we said, as Hashem said, my mind is not your mind, my understanding is not your understanding. What are you trying to do, right? So how can we try to explain the reason of the mitzvahs? All of them will be according to our own logic, limited logic. Okay.